Ok, ahí estamos. Hey, hello, Andrea, good morning.
Hello, teacher Gaby, good morning.
How are you?
Fine, and you?
Well, I'm fine. I already had my breakfast. Do you have your breakfast?
Yes.
Well, in my case, I ate beans, eggs, cream, and I had a cup of coffee with milk. What do you have for breakfast?
One coffee. Mm-hmm. And what do you say, pan?
Bread.
Ah, and bread.
Okay, so do you like pancakes?
Yes, and you?
Yes, it's my favorite breakfast. What is your favorite breakfast?
Food, typical food.
Salvadorian breakfast?
Yes.
Yes, I love it. Hey, do you like cereal with milk?
Do you like decir?
Cereal? Cereal. ¿Te gusta el cereal con leche? Do you like cereal with milk? Yes,
¿cómo,
I do, what, or no, I don't.
¿Cómo, what do you say, más o menos?
So-so.
So-so.
Well, in my case, I don't like cornflakes. I like crispies. What's your favorite cereal?
My favorite cereal is crispy.
Crispy, okay. Well, do you like fruits?
Yes.
What's your favorite?
Apple.
Mm-hmm.
But mango se dice igual.
Mango. Mango.
Mango. And
do you like watermelon?
No.
Pineapple?
Yes.
What do you prefer, pineapple or apples?
Pineapple.
Why? ¿Por qué? Because it's delicious.
Because it's delicious.
Ah, okay. So
very delicious.
Yes, yes, it is. So let's talk about music. What's your favorite music, Andrea?
My favorite music is salsa.
Ok, ahora ahí me puedes regresar la pregunta y decirme, ¿and you?
¿And you?
Ajá, ok, otra vez. What's your favorite music?
My favorite music is salsa, ¿and you?
Well, my favorite subject is, my favorite music is English music. Because when you listen English music, you can practice vocabulary, reading, writing. Do you like English music?
Yes.
How often, qué tan a menudo, how often do you listen English music? Sometimes, never, always. Never,
sometimes.
Never es nunca. Sometimes, a veces.
Mm-hmm.
Always, siempre. So, how often do you listen English music?
Sometimes.
Sometimes, okay, well, in my case, I like to listen when I am working. Cuando yo estoy trabajando, me gusta. I like to listen English music when I'm working. Let's talk about famous singer. Who's your favorite singer? Michael Jackson, Jennifer Lopez. Who's your favorite singer?
My favorite singer is James Arthur.
Okay.
And Bruno Mars.
Hey, I like Bruno Mars too, but the only song that I like it is When I See Your Face. There's nothing I want to change. Just you're amazing, just the way you are. It's the only one that I like it. I don't like too much. I prefer Michael Jackson. Do you like Michael Jackson?
Yes.
What's your favorite song? My favorite is Thriller. You can do Thriller.
My favorite song is... ¿Puedo decir de todas? ¿De todo género?
Yes.
If the world was ending.
Ah, yes. That is a very nice song. Hey, sí. Do you like rancheras music?
No. Oh, banda? I like.
Banda. Hey, let's see. Let me try to memorize. Let me try to remember. Banda, banda. Uy, ya se me olvidó todas las canciones de banda, vos. Espérame. Hey, mention a famous banda singer. Yes. No. Noel.
La mejor de todas.
Ah, yeah, but the singer. Yeah, but the singer, who sings that song? ¿Quién canta esa canción? Who sings that song?
Who sings is Banda MS.
Ah, band it's a band. MS. Ah, it's sí. A band. Okay. Hey, do you like rock music?
No. And you?
It depends. For example, I like... what's the name of this band? Is But the song is in the end when I saw her and try so far in the end is that I even love you. Se me ha olvidado el nombre de este grupo. But I have just one rock band. Se llama... Dios mío, ¿qué me está pasando? Se me acaba de... Well, I don't like... There is one band that I like the music, but I can't remember now. Do you like romantic music?
Yes.
For example?
Río Roma?
No, I don't know. Who are they?
¿Cómo se llama este?
I don't like romantic. I don't like romantic music. I prefer cumbia, Salvadorian cumbia.
I like.
Can you dance?
Yes.
What can you dance? Salsa, merengue. What can you dance?
What? How do you say? Ahí
sería. Yo de puedo. Todo un poco. Yo puedo bailar. Okay. Ahí sería. I can dance. I can dance. Dance. Que dice, significa yo puedo, ¿verdad? I can dance all kind of music, todo tipo de música.
I can dance all time, así.
Yes, all kind of music. So, can you dance bachata?
Yes.
No, I can't.
And you?
No, I cannot. Can you dance salsa?
Yes, and you?
Yes, I can. Can you dance reggaeton chuco?
No.
Yes, me too. I don't like it. So let's talk about next topic. You. Mention a topic. Any topic. Menciona cualquier tema. You. Topic.
De tema de.
Ah, o sea, ahora vos escoge un tema.
What is your favorite? How do you say? Película.
Movie.
What do you say, movie?
What is your favorite movie?
What is your favorite movie?
Well, I have many. Tengo muchas. I have many. Number one. Well, first of all, ese first of all significa primero que nada. First of all. First of all, my favorite kind, mi tipo de películas favoritas son, my favorite kind of movies are action movies and comedy movies. I don't like scary movies or romantic movies or science fiction movies. For example, science fiction movies like Avengers, Harry Potter, no, I don't like it. So I don't like scary movies, romantic movies, and science fiction movies. But I like action and comedy. My favorite action movie is Fast and Furious.
Mm-hmm.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Todas las que ha sacado. My favorite comedy movie is I have many. Grow up. Son como niños. Grow up. And you?
And my favorite movies and romantic.
Mm-hmm.
And comedy.
In comedy. Hey, do you like Adam Sandler, the actor?
Yes.
He's very funny. He's very funny, right?
Sí.
Sí o yes?
Yes.
Hey, do you like, yes, Adam Sandler is one of my favorite actors. Do you like Eugenio Derbez?
Yes, I like it.
Yes, me too. I like the movies. Well, what do you prefer, Adam Sandler or Eugenio Derbez?
Adam Sandler.
Why?
Because he's more.
Para decir que es más divertido, is funnier.
Is funnier.
En ese caso, para decir que es más divertido, funnier, mm-hmm. más divertido. Well, yes, in my case, I prefer Eugenio Derbez. Is he from Mexico? Is he from Mexico?
Yes.
Ahí sería, yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
Okay, and where is Adam Sandler from? ¿De dónde es Adam Sandler? He is from United States.
United States.
Andrea, where are you from?
I am from El Salvador. And you?
I'm from El Salvador. I live in Santa Tecla. Where do you live?
I live in Ahuachapán.
Well, can you describe the place where you live, please? For example, I'm going to give you my example. I live in Santa Tecla. There are many banks, many malls, many parks. There is a hospital. Estoy inventando. There is mm-hmm. a hospital in front of my house. There is a shopping center next to my house. I have 1, 2, 3, 4 parks in my city. Can you please describe Ahuachapán?
I live in Ahuachapán. There is very benches.
Mm-hmm.
There is a park.
Mm-hmm.
There is very, very buses.
Uh-huh.
There is very bicycle.
Mm-hmm.
And very stores.
Excellent. Well, in my case, Santa Tecla is big. What about Ahuachapán? Is big or small?
It's big. No, it's big. It's small.
It's small. Ah, okay. Yeah. Well, is there a beach in your city?
No,
there isn't.
No, there isn't.
Okay, si te pregunto, por ejemplo, ¿hay una playa en tu ciudad? Si hay, yes, there is. No hay, no, there isn't.
No, there isn't.
Is there a beach in your city?
No, there isn't.
Is there a river, río? Is there a river in your city?
Yes, there is.
Is there a lake, lago? Is there a lake in your city?
No, there isn't.
No, there isn't. Okay, well, I like to live in Santa Tecla because, me gusta vivir en Santa Tecla porque, mm-hmm. I like to live in Santa Tecla because the weather, ¿qué es weather?
Dime.
Because the weather is it's nice because the weather, well, right now, ahorita mismo, right now, the weather is sunny. What's the weather in your city now?
And the weather is right now sunny.
Sunny. Hey, what's your favorite weather? Sunny.
My favorite.
Rainy. Winter, cuando hace mucho viento. Aunque en nuestro caso en El Salvador solo tenemos summer and rainy. Solo tenemos invierno y verano. So what's your favorite? Sunny or rainy?
My favorite weather is sunny. And you? Why?
Well, I'm going to give you my opinion. My favorite weather is sunny too because I like to go to the beach. What's your favorite weather?
My favorite weather is sunny because I like hot. ¿Cómo podría? Okay.
Yes, no, yes, it is perfect. Muy bien. So, hey, do you like to go to the beach?
Yes, and you?
Well, it depends because sometimes it's really hot and I don't like that weather, but sometimes I prefer to go to the mountain. For example, I like to go to Cerro Verde. What do you prefer, Andrea, to go to the beach or to go to the mountain?
To go to the beach.
Why?
Because
in my case, I like to go to the beach because I like to swim in the swimming pool.
Sería, no, es como, me gusta más el mar. ¿Cómo sería?
I like the beach more.
I like the beach more because, ¿cómo se dice? But how do you say entre amigos y familia?
I like to go to the beach with my family and friends.
I like to go to the beach with my family and friends.
Hey, please, talking about family, hablando de la familia, talking about family, I'm going to present my family. Okay, in my case, I live with my parents, my mom and my dad. I have two brothers, but my middle brother, mi hermano de en medio, my middle brother lives in United States. He works in a restaurant. His name is Daniel. Daniel is 25 years old. My little brother, he lives with me. He is 22 years old and he works in an office. And my name is Gabriela, and I work as an English teacher. Can you please tell me about your family, Andrea?
In my case,
live. Si no, mira, si no te corrijo, hija, es porque lo estás haciendo bien. Por eso que no te he corregido, porque son detallitos los que te equivocas, fíjate. Okay.
In my case, live two brothers. One brother, no sería así, ¿verdad? Big brother.
My big brother, ajá.
My big brother. Here, Diego.
His name is, ¿cómo es hombre?
His name is Diego. He is 18 years old. A small brother.
My little brother.
Little brother. His name is
Carlos. ¿Cómo es hombre? His name is.
His name is Carlos. Here is 13 years old.
And you
live, and I am 17 years old.
Are you working? ¿Estás trabajando?
No.
No, I am not.
No, I am not.
Okay. Yes, please.
¿Cómo se, how do you say? Y también vive.
And also,
my grandmother and my grandfather and my dog and my, how do you say, tío?
My uncle. Ah, okay, excellent. Well, in my case, I have a dog. His name is Teodoro. My dog is 4 years old. Can you please tell me about your dog?
My dog is here. She is Muffy.
Her name is Muffy.
She is 5 years old.
Oh, it's one year older than Theo. Well,
sí.
What do you prefer, dogs or cats?
Dogs.
Why?
Because I like it more.
Yes, I like it more too. Me encanta. Muy bien, hija. Excelente. Te felicito. Yes, I prefer dogs because I like it more. So, let's change the topic. Vamos a cambiar el tema. So, the next topic is, escoge tú el tema, the next topic, el siguiente tema es, the next topic is,
deportes.
Sports, okay. So, well, in my case, I don't like to practice sports, but I like to go to the park and walk with my dog. What about you?
I like sport. Is basketball because it's very nice.
I cannot play basketball. Can you play soccer? Yes, I can. Oh no, I cannot.
No, I cannot.
Well, in my case, can you swim?
No, I cannot.
Yeah, in my case, yes, I can. I like to swim. Well, do you like to go to the gym?
¿Qué quiere decir eso?
¿Te gusta ir al gimnasio? Do you like to go to the gym?
¿Puedo decir más o menos?
So. In my case, no, I don't like to go to the gym. I prefer to watch Netflix or sleeping. Are my hobbies. Son mis pasatiempos. What are your hobbies?
My hobbies. See Netflix.
Watch. Puedo ir de ver televisión. Watch Netflix.
And play basketball.
Hey, talking about Netflix, do you like to watch series? ¿Te gusta ver series? Do you like to watch series?
My favorite series is Grey's Anatomy.
Hey, most people mention that series, Grey's Anatomy. I don't like, I haven't seen, yo nunca le he visto, I haven't seen, but one of my favorite hobbies is watching Netflix. And I have two favorite series. Number one, Ugly Betty. Have you heard about Ugly Betty?
No.
In Spanish, is Betty La Fea.
Oh, yes.
Have you seen it?
No.
It's a, I recommend to you to watch it. It's very nice because it's a soap opera. Soap opera es novela. Mm-hmm. It's a soap opera, but it's very nice. And the second series that is one of my favorite is Cobra Kai. Mm-hmm. Have you seen Cobra Kai?
No.
It's like Karate Kid. Have you seen Karate Kid? It's about,
Yes.
It's about karate. Hey, do you like karate, the sport?
So.
It's dangerous? Do you consider it's dangerous?
No.
Well, in my case, yes, it is. I consider it's very dangerous. I don't like to practice karate. I prefer to practice basketball. Yes. So I have a question. How often do you practice basketball?
¿Qué quiere decir?
How often? Lo que te pregunté hace bastante. Que te dije how often. No me acuerdo qué fue lo que te pregunté, pero es ¿qué tan a menudo? How often do you practice basketball? Never, sometimes, always?
Sometimes.
For example, sometimes on Monday, on Saturday, on Friday.
How do you say no tengo días exactos?
I don't have
exactly
days. Okay, una vez más. How often do you practice basketball?
I don't have exactly days.
Okay, let's talk about what's the next topic. Choose the topic. What is the next topic?
Yes.
Okay, you choose one topic. Tú escoge un tema, el último.
Sing.
Cantar. Okay. Okay, yes.
You like sing?
Yes, I like to sing, but English song. Do you like to sing?
Yes.
What can you sing?
And sing.
Mm-hmm. Mm. What can you sing?
¿Cómo tú dices ahí de todo un poco?
All kind of music.
All kind of music.
Ese all kind es todo tipo de, y ahí solo le agregas. Por ejemplo, si yo digo all kind of food, ¿qué estoy diciendo?
All kind, ¿qué?
All kind of food, ¿qué estoy diciendo?
La comida, no.
Todo tipo de comida, o sea, ese all kind... Ese all kind significa todo tipo de. Por ejemplo, si yo digo all kind of music.
Todo tipo de música.
All kind of food.
Todo tipo de comida.
All kind of animals.
Todo tipo de animales.
Entonces, ese es all kind, significa todo eso. Ok, mira, hija, te felicito. Has hablado en inglés durante media hora. Pregunta, ¿sentís que te cuesta? ¿O qué es lo que sentís más difícil?
En algunas palabras que casi no las sé manejar. Solo eso, o sea, que algunas palabras no puedo decirlas, pero siento que es fácil hablarlo. Ajá, o sea, para algunas palabras.
Sí, ahorita sentís fácil hablarlo porque prácticamente hemos hecho, o sea, las preguntas que yo te hago son bien básicas. Porque es de un inglés básico.
Básico.
Mira, lo que sí me preocupa sí son tus hermanos. Porque a partir del otro mes, o sea, eso ya voy a ver cómo lo manejo. Porque a partir del otro mes ya la conversación ya no va a ser, hey, what's your favorite color? What's your favorite food? Ya no. Porque ese tema usted, bueno, tú ya lo manejas. Sino que ya para el siguiente nivel ya serían preguntas así como que, ¿do you consider English is important? ¿Consideras que el inglés
es importante?
Entonces ya vos me tenés que decir sí, yo considero que es importante, o no, yo considero que no es importante, y ya me tienen que dar una razón del por qué. Entonces ya el what's your favorite color ya no, porque yo sé que vos ya lo manejás. En el caso de Diego, si él fuera más responsable, igual, yo sé que estaría al mismo nivel tuyo. En el caso de Carlitos, pues con él sí es un poco más lento el aprendizaje, pero sí, no, o sea, voy a hablar yo con tu mamá porque en el caso de ellos sí me preocupa, porque no puedo pasar al siguiente nivel si ellos no han,
en que
han
yo
estado
no estoy...
en clase, uh-huh. pues, y no te puedo sí. tener, y no te puedo tener a vos en el siguiente nivel con el mismo nivel de ellos. O sea, sí. no, porque te, vos te vas a atrasar y te vas a aburrir. Pero como ya manejas eso, entonces sí te felicito un montón porque te voy a decir algo, a vos no te va a costar allá. Así te lo digo, a vos no te va a costar allá. Ahora bien, ¿en qué es lo que falla vos? Por ejemplo, me dijiste, yo algo así, yo vivo con mis abuelos, ese, la palabra con se te olvida. O sea, vos decís, I live grand, me dijiste así. Live grandmother, o sea, yo te entendí uh-huh. que me dijiste yo vivo con mi abuela, pero tenés que hacer más estructurada. I live with, con. Entonces, uh-huh. los conectores se te olvidan a vos. I live with my grandmother, my grandpa, my uncle, my brothers, etc. Entonces, esas uh-huh. palabritas de con son las que a vos se te olvidan. Otra cosa, eso también. Yo te dejé que respondieras yes y no, pero en sí. realidad en el inglés no se responde así. Espérame, regálame 10 segundos. No, hombre, te dije que me esperara 10 segundos y aquí enfrente se quedó en vendedor. Vaya, otra cosa. Yo te dejé que me contestaras yes y no, pero en el inglés, por ejemplo, te voy a hacer una pregunta. Do you like salsa music?
Yes, I like.
Vaya, ahí sí. Vaya, vos podés responder.
Mira, yes, pero tengo que formular, tengo
ajá,
que...
Ah, ahora bien, observa. La pregunta comienza, Do you like salsa music? Poder responder de dos formas. Yes, I do. Uh-huh. Si es positivo. No, I don't.
I do. No, I don't.
Si es negativo. Positivo, yes, I do. Negativo, no, I don't.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Ahora bien, si yo te pregunto, do you like pupusas? Puedes responder, yes, I like it. Yes, I do, no. Igual que la vez pasada. Uh-huh. No, I don't.
No, I don't.
Ahora bien, en uh-huh. español nosotros decimos, Andrea, ¿te gusta la sandía? Sí, fíjate que a mí me gusta la sandía. Nosotros volvemos a repetir lo mismo. En el inglés ellos no se complican. Viene alguien y te dice, Andrea, do you like chocolate? Yes, I do. Sí, sí me gusta. Y no es necesario que digas, yes, I do, I like
chocolate. Me gusta chocolate.
No es necesario. Uh-huh. Con solo yes, I do, suficiente. Vamos a hacer una práctica. Vamos a, todo lo que te pregunte, me vas a contestar en positivo. Andrea, do you like English music?
Yes, I do.
Do you like the color blue?
Yes, I do.
Do you like the dogs?
Yes, I do.
Do you like pupusas?
Yes, I do.
Do you like tomatoes?
Yes, I do.
Do you like pizza?
Yes, I do.
Do you like burgers?
Yes, I do.
Do you like to watch Netflix?
Yes, I do.
Do you like to go to the mountain?
Yes, I do.
Do you like to walk in the park?
Yes, I do.
Vaya, no se dice yes, solo que yes, I do, ¿verdad? Completo. Ahora mm-hmm. vamos con sí. negativo. Todo
no,
lo que
I
te
don't.
Pregunte, negativo. Do you like chocolate?
No, I don't.
Do you like cats?
No, I don't.
Do you like watching romantic movies?
No, I don't.
Do you like scary movies?
No, I don't.
Do you like burgers?
No, I don't.
Do you like to go to the beach?
No, I don't.
Vaya, esa es la única diferencia. que no se dice yes. Solo, o sea, allá te preguntan algo, yes I do o no I don't.
Tengo que especificarla mejor.
Ajá, cabal. O sea, porque es gramática, para ellos es gramática. Uh-huh. Ahora bien, también yo te hice otra pregunta. Yo te dije a vos, can you swim? ¿Puedes nadar? Ahora bien, ahí no se responde yes I do. Uh-huh. El auxiliar es can. Can you swim? Positivo.
Yes, I can.
Yes, I can. Negativo. No, no, I cannot.
I don't. No, I cannot.
No, I cannot. Ya te voy a enseñar, ya te voy a dar una pista, una estrategia para que veas cómo, cuándo es que se usa y cuándo no. Otra vez. Positivo. Can you dance?
Yes, I can.
Can you swim?
Yes, I can.
Can you speak Spanish?
Yes, I can.
Can you speak English?
Yes, I can.
Can you speak Japanese?
Yes, I can.
Can you drive a car?
Yes, I can.
Can you ride a bike?
Yes, I can.
Can you cook?
Yes, I can.
Hoy vamos con negativo.
No, I cannot, de verdad.
No, I cannot. Negativo, yo no puedo. Can you swim?
No, I cannot.
Can you dance salsa?
No, I cannot.
Can you speak English?
No, I cannot.
Can you speak Spanish?
No, I cannot.
Can you dance bachata?
No, I cannot.
Can you fly?
No, I cannot.
Vaya, Gaby, ¿y cómo voy a saber cuándo voy a responder yes I do y, o yes I can? Dependiendo del auxiliar. Ajá, cabal. Uh-huh. Si yo te digo, hoy vamos a mezclar, hoy me vas a contestar de acuerdo a tu información personal, ya sea positiva, uh-huh, negativa, como vos quieras. ¿Do you like pizza?
Yes, I like.
Yes, I like it, o yes, I do. Uh-huh. ¿Do you like pacayas?
No, I don't.
No, I don't. Can you dance reggaeton?
No, I cannot.
Mm-hmm. Can you fly?
No, I cannot.
Can you speak Japanese?
¿Qué es Japanese?
¿Puedes hablar japonés? Can you speak Japanese?
No, I cannot.
Do you like to watch movies?
Yes, I can.
Yes, I do. Do you?
Yes, I do.
Do you like to listen English music?
Yes, I like.
Do you like to swim?
No. No. No.
No, I don't.
No, I don't.
Vaya, ahora ya viste cómo nos comenzamos a trabar un poquito, ¿verdad? Pero es fácil. Si la pregunta comienza con do, yo voy a responder yes, I do o no, I don't.
Ajá.
Si la pregunta comienza con can, yes, I can o no, I can not.
No, I can.
Ahora bien, ¿por qué no puedo decir yo, por ejemplo, haceme una pregunta con do?
Do you speak Spanish?
Do you?
Do you?
Ajá, otra vez, completa la oración.
Do you speak Spanish?
Vale, te voy a responder en una forma mal gramaticalmente. Uh-huh. No, I cannot. ¿Por qué no puedo responder así, Gaby?
Porque no lleva, no es el auxiliar can.
Ajá, exacto. Ahora bien, y otra cosa, es como nosotros en español. Tengo la palabra canción. ¿A dónde lleva uh-huh. la tilde? En la O.
En la O.
¿Qué pasa si yo le quito la tilde? Canción. O sea, ¿qué es eso, va? Entonces, lo mismo es en inglés. Así como nosotros tenemos reglas gramaticales, también
ellos la tienen.
Ajá, entonces vos no puedes llegar allá diciendo, te pregunta alguien, ¿Do you speak English? No, I cannot. O sea, se te va a entender sí. porque te va a entender. Porque ajá. es como que a mí un gringo me diga, canción. Yo sé que está diciendo canción, pero
canción.
Me le voy a quedar viendo raro, pero le entendí. Ahora, obviamente no es el objetivo. El objetivo es que ustedes, en este caso, lo hablen bien. Ahora bien, para finalizar estos 15 minutos, te voy a enseñar algo que es bien chivo y es bien original. Que eso lo hago bastante en mi academia. Esto lo hago ya cuando estamos en el nivel 2. En tu caso, siento yo que ya estás lista. Te voy a poner un video en inglés que dura 5 minutos. Te aconsejo que tengas lápiz y papel a la mano en qué anotar. Lo primero que vas a hacer es, simple y sencillamente, escribir 10 verbos en inglés que logres ver en el video. ¿Cómo así, Gaby? Si ves que ellos comen, ¿qué verbo voy a escribir?
Food.
Eat.
Eat.
Si ves que ellos caminan, ¿qué verbo voy a poner? Walk.
Walk.
Si ves que ellos corren, ¿qué verbo voy a poner?
Run.
Si ves que ellos saltan, ¿qué verbo voy a poner?
Jumping.
Entonces, eso, cabal, eso es lo que yo quiero. 10 verbos que logres ver. Y en el punto número 2, necesito que en inglés me digas, como puedas, de qué trata el video. ¿Cómo así, Gaby? Vas a describir, por ejemplo, Gaby, pero yo todavía no lo hablo bien. Entonces, vamos a comenzar con algo bien sencillo. The video is about. El video es acerca de. The video, te lo voy a escribir en el chat. Sí, mira. The video is about. El video trata acerca de. Y vos podés poner. The video is about some friends. El video trata de algunos amigos. They are, ¿a dónde están ellos?
En el parque.
They are in the park. Ellos están en el parque. Así puedes comenzar. El video trata de unos amigos que están en el parque y ahí puedes poner. Y ellos están jugando. They are playing, jumping, eating, sleeping. Ahí puedes ver, vos jugar, ya comenzás a conjugar los verbos. Como ya te los podés, comenzás a describir. Si yo veo que están hablando, they are talking. Si yo veo que ellos están corriendo, they are running. Ahora bien, también puedes hacer lo mismo. In the... Y este es más fácil. In the video I saw. Ya te lo voy a mandar ahí. En el video yo vi. Recordá que el saw es el pasado de sí. Sí es sí. Ver. Saw, vi, ¿verdad? En el video yo vi. Y comenzás a escribir, a decirme todo el vocabulario. Si viste flowers, si viste people, si viste clothes, si viste animals, si viste colors. ¿Me doy a entender?
Sí.
Ok, y con eso vamos a terminar la clase. Ok. Please pay attention to the video.
Hi, my name is Laura and I am 15 years old. I am an optimistic and energetic person. I have many great friends. I like dancing, reading books, playing volleyball, and cooking in my spare time. I have long, curly blonde hair and blue eyes. I am tall and slim. My favorite color is red. That's why I love wearing red clothes.
What is she like?
She is cheerful and fun to be with.
What does she look like?
She is brunette, she has a ponytail and blue eyes. She is very pretty.
How old is she?
She is 6 years old.
What is she wearing?
She is wearing a t-shirt, a red skirt and red shoes.
Hello! Dinner is here! Cheer up! Stop being sad, young man.
What is she like?
She is optimistic, nice and patient.
What does she look like?
She has black eyes. She is pretty, tall, and rather plump. She wears her hair in a bun. She also wears glasses.
How old is she?
She is in her mid-40s.
What is she wearing?
She is wearing a blue uniform.
What is he like?
He is confident and positive.
What does he look like?
He has dark short hair, black eyes and a big smile. He is handsome and muscular.
How old is he?
He is around 30 years old.
What is he wearing?
He is wearing a gym suit.
What is he like?
He is mean to other kids.
What does he look like?
He has short brown hair and green eyes.
How old is he?
He is 7 years old.
What is he wearing?
He is wearing a blue polo shirt, black trousers, and white sneakers.
What is he like?
He is passionate about music.
What does he look like?
He has medium-length blonde hair and black eyes.
How old is he?
He is around 20 years old.
What is he wearing?
He is wearing an elegant black suit, black shoes, and a red bow tie.
What is she like?
She's nice and friendly.
What does she look like?
She is beautiful. She has long, wavy red hair and blue eyes. She's slim and tall.
How old is she?
She is around 18 years old.
What is she wearing?
She is wearing a short black dress and black shoes.
What is he like?
He is intelligent and self-confident.
What?
Okay, we are going to stop here for the time. So, what is the video about? ¿De qué trata el video, Andrea?
The video is about some friends. Mm-hmm. They are in the park. Mm-hmm. They are talking and playing. Mm-hmm. And very people, they are, how do you say, ejercicio?
Working out. Te lo voy a escribir en el chat, verano. Puede ser, they are exercising. Y lo más correctamente dicho, ahí te lo voy a mandar. Ahí está, working out.
Working out. Uh-huh. And very people. Mm-hmm. They are working out. And one person is touch piano.
Playing the piano, ahí se ocupa play. Mm. Playing the piano.
Playing the piano. And how do you say in conclusion?
In conclusion.
In conclusion, the video. It's about the very people talking and
in English
expressing.
Excelente. So vocabulary, ¿qué cosas o objetos vistes? Yo vi, y ahí comenzas a mencionar los objetos. I saw a table, I saw a woman, I saw a window.
I saw a window, I saw a television.
A gym.
I saw a gym, I saw a park, I saw benches.
A man, a girl,
and hospital.
Mm-hmm. And the bears?
I saw a school.
I saw a school.
I saw many people.
I saw some, algunos estudiantes, some students.
Students. I saw door.
A locker.
I saw a locker. And and shoes.
And
shield.
¿Cómo se dice teatro en inglés? Yo vi un teatro.
I saw teatro.
Theater.
¿Cómo?
Theater.
Theater.
Ya te lo voy a escribir. Ahí está. Se pronuncia.
I saw theater.
Sí.
I saw theater.
Theater, ajá. I saw
a flowers.
Uh-huh.
I saw.
¿Cómo sería? Yo vi un restaurante.
I saw restaurant.
A restaurant. Uh-huh. Yo vi dos mesas.
I saw two tables.
Uh-huh.
I saw.
Yo vi un maestro.
I saw teacher. I saw
una pizarra.
Eso te lo voy a decir, pero se me olvidó.
Board.
I saw board.
I saw a board.
I saw a board.
Mencioname los verbos que lograste identificar. Ahí hay más cosas, mira.
And I saw talking. I saw playing. I saw coach.
Mm-hmm.
I saw working out.
Mm-hmm.
I saw I saw arrive.
Mm-hmm.
I saw desk.
Uh-huh. Okay, desk, creo que no es verbo.
No, ask.
Ask. Uh-huh.
I saw study.
Mm-hmm.
I saw
Va, con esa pregunta termino.
Mm-hmm.
Do you like the video? Yes. No.
Yes.
And why?
Yes. Yes, I can.
Yes, I do. Because, do you like the video?
Yes, I see. Yes, I do. Because.
¿Cómo se diría porque yo puedo, porque yo pude practicar inglés, el listening, la escritura, vocabulario? ¿Cómo se diría eso? Yo pude aprender because I could learn.
Because I could learn English.
English. For example, por ejemplo, vocabulary.
Vocabulary.
¿Cómo sería escuchar? Listening. ¿Cómo sería escribir?
Listening and
writing. ¿Cómo sería leer? Reading. Vaya. Te voy a dar 30 segundos. La misma pregunta te voy a hacer. Do you like the video? Y contéstame bien, te voy a dar 30 segundos para que prepares tu respuesta y con eso termino. 30 segundos para que te prepares a partir de ahorita. ¿Lista?
Estoy pensando todavía un poco.
Va, te doy 15 segundos.
Vaya.
Ready?
Yes.
Okay. Do you like the video?
I like it.
Why?
Because I like the video. We do. I change myself.
Mm-hmm.
How to read.
Mm-hmm.
English. Better.
Better, uh-huh.
Pronunciation in the learn more verbs.
In learn more verbs. Excelente, hija. Muy bien, te felicito. Vamos muy bien. Descansa el fin de semana, no te voy a dejar tarea ni nada, lo has hecho muy, muy bien. Te felicito, hija. Nos vemos el día lunes.